السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على سيدي محمد وعلى من والاه وعلى التابعين وتابعيهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. طبتم وطاب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة منزلا. I'm bear witness there is no God but only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty. And I'm bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and sealing prophet for all mankind. Peace and blessing upon him, his follower, his companion, his wives, his family, and his follower until the day of judgment. Allahumma amin. Tonight, the Isra and Mi'raj, I am not going to talk about the details of it. I'm going to just try as much I can tonight, inshallah ta'ala, to answer the questions, which is a lot of people making a lot of fitna for the people, that in the Isra of a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, by his body and spirit, or just the spirit only. Let's cover that little few points here, and I'm telling you that subject, and that topic specifically, alaykum as-salamu wa barakatuh, it was even a problem for me. You know, when we study, when we went to the university to study engineering, I am man thinking about numbers. The speed of the light, Dr. Sayed, it's a 300,000 kilometer or mile in the second, or kilometer in the second. So, and imagine about how the galaxy and the moon, the light from the sun to come to the earth is 8 minutes to come over. And here we consider this is like a next door neighbor. And how Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after we study as in science people, and study about the galaxy and the million of years of light speed, how come? And not only this, but how his physical body can handle such a pressure. And all this is whole idea the Quran provides for you and I, it's go along with brain or not. I know in the end of it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to do everything. And he is the creator, and he يقول للشيء يكون فيكون. But still, some people have a problem with it. Why? Why? How Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam really, he make the journey and come back again. And the hadith he said, he when he come back again, his farsh, his bed is still warm. So something amazing happened right there. And the people, they said, Prophet Muhammad, he being by spirit only. So if the Isra and Mi'raj happened by the spirit only, there is no any miracle in that. You know, when you sleep, or when I sleep, my spirit, my soul is free to go anywhere. And she can go to the moon, can go to the sun, and can go to land, will never ever see it. With a second, sometimes I see the dream. I see I come into United States and I'm making business and making money and I travel back to Egypt. And you know, I'm shaking the people's hand and giving people a hug and somebody such and such. All this is happening in such a second, less than a second. It's one dakarabaya, it's a little spark, electric spark from your brain coming and you see all this vision. So it's not really miracle at all. So this number one, if the Isra and Mi'raj happened by the spirit, there is no miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to talk about it. And he put it in his final book and final revelation and people talk about it. And it became very big test for the believer. So this number one. Number two, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, you remember the Isra and Mi'raj happened after Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness. He lost Khadija radiallahu anha. He lost his uncle, Abu Talib. He lost, and he went to the Ta'if, and been humiliated, and been dishonored, and been stoned. And he made the dua. Oh, you guys memorizing this beautiful dua. اللهم أنت ربي إلى من تكلني. And all the rest of the dua, he shake the hills, the land and heaven. And Jibreel Karam alayhi salam came, Ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you want me to slam the two mountains and finish them, but al-rahmatul muhda, wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alameen. He said, maybe, subhanallah, this hadith I was talking to someone, some student, yesterday, just yesterday, from a Taif. And I said, wallahi, you are the result of da'wah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Otherwise, you guys, you're not going to be here. And he was praying. The guys, mashallah, very, very good believers and good muwahideen, shabab, talaba in Long Beach University. So, ha'ula, hiya hasad da'wah Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he went to honor this prophet being humiliated and being dishonored that much. And he be sad, and his family against him, his people in Quraysh against him. Nobody want to believe in him. Yeah, people, I am trying to lead you to the paradise, and nobody want to listen. Everybody making fun of him. Everybody dishonor him. So here, the Lord of the heaven and earth get involved, and when he get involved, I'm talking to the people. They say the spirit only. When he get involved, he allowed only his spirit to go. And this is doesn't. So this is the second point. It doesn't make any sense. And I'm telling you, I'm going to prove you for tonight that wallahi, what is make me believe that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he making Isra and Mi'raj by his spirit and body, it's ants. You know the ants? Have it in front of me. And this ants make me, I am Tariq Muhammad, that believe that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Isra happened by his body and his spirit. But let's go, let's talk about this people or the claim they're claiming about it. Now, let's go for Surah Al-Isra. Surah Al-Isra, as everybody, every scholar knows, call it Surah Makkiyah. And the ulama, especially Dr. Sayyid, he makes his book Al-Bayan, and he making a lot of tafsir in it. You know, the people for explain and interpret the Quran by five ways. Number one, if you want to explain the Quran, first by the Quran. So this is verse, you're going to look in the Quran, you'll find another verse, explain that verse. Or by the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam hadith. Or by the Sahaba, or by Ijma' al-Ummah. Five ways to try to understand the text of the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, fi sadr Surah Al-Isra, subhanalladhi. What does it mean, subhanalladhi? Mean that what is going to happen, what is going to hear you guys, it's tahtaj, it's need, subhan. Subhanallah mean that munazzah an kulli naqsin wa aybin, bal huwa kamilun wal kamalu kulluhu fi fi'lih. Mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's 100% pure from any negativity. Subhan, munazzah. يعني سبحان الذي. So al-Isra wal-Mi'raj يحتاج إلى سبحان. سبحان Allah, the one he doesn't make mistake, the one who doesn't make any negative or something not complete and perfect. سبحان الذي أسرى. أسرى يعني, أسرى يعني, al-Isra هو المشي أو السفر ليلا. So whole travel happened in the night. قلت ليلة الإيه؟ الإسراء والمعراج. سرى الرجل يعني معناه أنه إيه؟ He walked in the night time. It doesn't even, the daytime it doesn't come to him. So whole event happened what? إسراء. Allah, he perfect expression to explain the time of إسراء. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده. بعبده. بعبده mean that the soul of Adam, if the only soul, he can do it, but the spirit of his is a servant. For example, so al-abd or abdihi need two things: body, physical body like you and I, and a spirit. Who say that? Let's go to the Quran. Huh? Quran, what he said? الذي ينهى عبدا إذا صلى. عبدا إذا صلى. العبد when you صلي, when عبد, the servant of Allah, when he pray by his spirit only, by his spirit and his physical body. Yeah. فالعبودية والعبد هنا, here, it's mean Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم by his body, by his spirit, by his soul, all package, he moved right there. الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا. And I'm gonna just get off the topic a little bit, and I like to call the believer and muhadeen, انظر, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tight between المسجد الحرام, but we have it right now, إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. He's telling you, this is your amana. This is your first qibla. Do not give it up. Don't say, oh, Palestinian, this is your own problem. Solve it with the Jewish. Oh, this is politics. I'm telling you this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tied both of them. And he give you as an amana. And this amana, don't think you take amana and that's it. No. What you did for this amana? Did you reserve the amana? Did you protect the amana? Did you defend about the Masjid al-Aqsa? A lot of people, they think the conflict between Palestinian and is not at all. هذا صراع دين عقيدة. This is conflict of faith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you al-Masjid al-Aqsa, مثل al-Masjid al-Haram, the first Qibla. And the third Masjid, you can travel and you تشد إليه الرحال. وهو أمانة. وهو وقف. وقف إسلامي يعني. يعني you. The one sit down over there in the corner, he doesn't listen to me and look at his phone. He have a part in that masjid. And the people in the phone right now, in the online, they knows they have a part in that masjid. I have a part in that masjid. Doesn't matter, it's small or big, but this is part, this is mine. It's mine. Just like the masjid al-haram. Okay? So that's it. هذا وقف. وقف وقفه الله إلى المؤمنين واستودعه في سورة الإسراء. So الإسراء هو فعل خارق, يعني super nature, معجزة. What the mean معجزة? ما هي المعجزة? المعجزة هي كسر لقانون الطبيعة. When you broke the nature law. For example, if I have a stone and I throw it up, if she keep going, this is mu'jiza. If she come back again, this is mu'jiza, right? So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he another term. It's make me as in a study math. الذي أسرى بعبده من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. And you have also, العلماء قال لك إيه. And I'm gonna leave the details. I'm sorry. I have. Let me turn my phone off. I apologize. No. It's not Sheikh Ali. فاحنا سميها ايه? We call this journey is Isra and Mi'raj. Mi'raj by itself, it's a miracle. Do you know, and this is the people studying astronomy and Fada and NASA, he said there is no straight line in the heaven. يعني في السماء, حركة السماء والأجرام, all the movement you have, there is no straight line at all. And this is what happened. He said al-Isra wal-Su'ud, if the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم صعد, mean that he grown up. No, he said Mi'raj. What Mi'raj? Al-Mi'raj هو الصعود بشكل دائري, that you go up, but in circle way. And imagine, yeah, just like a spider, like a spring. You know, it doesn't go straight. It doesn't go from here up. It doesn't. Even if you try to do it, you know, imagine this is the land. Sorry. Imagine this is the land. And you go from here, the land is going to move. Look at this. Look at my finger and keep moving. At the end of it, you'll find you're going This is the reason we have Surah Al-Ma'arij. And this is miracle, scientific miracle to tell that's the Quran from 1,400 years ago. He telling you there is no straight line in the heaven or the sky or the movement in the universe. Is Ma'arij. الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام ليلة الإسراء والمعراج. So what the ants then? Why me, the ants make me believe this? And I'm gonna close with this. I look to say it, so I know, and we take too much time for. We don't want to make your night too long. I study civil engineer, and one day we have a six engineer. We have a city. They call it El Zagazig City. People in Malaya and probably gonna they know that El Zagazig City. They hire some. Student like us making a project to graduate, and he said we need to redesign the city of Zagazig again. So that's no problem. Mean that you're gonna relocate the police department, the hospital, the highway, how you can feed this with the water, where the main river, where all this, where the source of water, where all these beautiful things we have to put it. So it's gonna be the dynamic of war, good and nice. And what happened? We have like 4 meter and 3 meter map. All the city of Zagazig being drawn in that map. And we were thinking, how can we take an opinion? Let's do this, let's do that. And in the end of it, all of them, they left home, and it's happened to be in my department, all this. So I tried to cover, I tried to, يعني ألم الليلة وألم الماب. I tried to, you know, put it together. So, but I realized that you have an ants walk in the corner of this map. Map, and you have a little or ants, small ants walking in the corner in that map. It's what's very weird a little bit. It's like a brown, bigger than usual, but it's not too big. It's kind of small, but it's not like small ants we have, but it's big. So I said, well, between me and you, and I cannot really carry it by my hand. I said, maybe it can bite me or something. So I tried to, I take that, the corner of that map, and I link it to the corner of that map, and suddenly, this ant's moving from this corner with one step to other side. Just one step. I said, wow, that's ants. Stabbed all this is 2 meter, and the city of Zagazig within one step only. So here, subhanallah al-azim, the flashback coming to my brain. And I said, well, I am the Lord of the map. I am the one changing everything. Yes. And I move the things I want. And I able to just lower or bring the two side of the map to each other, so the ants within one step go from the whole right to the whole left within one step. Ants, it's ants. I said, I am a human being, I'm very limited with my power. So I said, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't make my math, or he doesn't allow Prophet Muhammad to go with this high speed and go with the first heaven and second heaven and third heaven and seventh heaven. Not only this, but Sidrat al-Muntaha, الذي يعني Quran, he recorded in Surah al-Najm, huh? And within 1 hour, and he came back again, and he go back to found, and his bed is still warm. So I said, I did it. I am not really, I don't have a superpower, but I'm just having this guy. The ants within one step making 2 meter within one step, ants. So I said, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I know he say, he huwa yaqulu lishay yakun fayakun. I understand that. But he said, maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he lower Sidrat al-Muntaha, because he is the physics, he's the designer, he's the engineer, all the physics. I am changing the hospital, I am changing the water, I'm changing the police department, I'll bring this here and this here. So Prophet Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he able to lower even the Sidr al-Muntaha for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to stamp with one step to be in Sidr al-Muntaha. It's happened for me. Very small trying happened in front of me. I did it. So how come for the Lord of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one He created the heaven and earth and He allowed it to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come and by his body and been recorded in two surahs. Surah Al-Isra to tell you about the value and how the abd Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam huwa ni'ma al-abd. After that he gonna, the detail inshallah we're gonna listen to Dr. Sayyid, but I'm telling you this. Al-abd kama qabalahu abuna Ibrahim alayhi salam fi samai al-ula Adam alayhi salam. Adam alayhi salam qala ahlan بالابن الصالح والولد الصالح والنبي الصالح ها ان اهلا فهو how come it doesn't happen for النبي الصالح والولد الصالح ومحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم احب خلق الله وسيد ولي ادم عليهم جميعا الصلاه والسلام. So here في ايه عظيمه جدا. The ايه number 60 in Surah Al-Isra. Look. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَمَا جَعَلْنَا الرُّؤْيَةَ الَّتِي أَرَيْنَاكَ إِلَّا فِتْنَةً لِلنَّاسِ. Wake up. Because after that journey, Allah people denied Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Some Muslim returned back to be kafir. But look at Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, look Muhammad, this is journey, and what you see during the journey, and what you see in Sidrat al-Muntaha, and what you have, and what you hear, all this, fitnah. Yeah, fitnah lil-nas. وَمَا جَعَلْنَا الرُّؤْيَا الَّتِي أَرَيْنَاكَ إِلَّا فِتْنَةً لِلنَّاسِ. So you, dear brothers, you're waiting for fitnah. Some people, some Muslim, he come to this topic and he shy to talk about it. Because you know what? He said, this is gonna bring topic to non-believer, and they think the non-believer said, no, come on, this is asatir, this is stories, this magic, this is never gonna happen, this has never happened, and make the people turn away, this fitna. But the believer, he said, eh, قالوا سمعنا يا رب وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير. Ya Allah, we hear and believe, yes. وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَثْبِيتًا. This is kind of a fitna for the believer, you and I. مَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا. Alhamdulillah, we get more and more belief. And let me tell you this. Allah, He call you believe and believer. You know why? Because other people, they're not believers. They don't believe by Muhammad. We didn't see Allah, but believe in Him. This is the reason we are a believer. They don't believe in Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They don't believe Allah, so they're not believers. Do you know what word believer coming from? You are a believer because you see or you believe unseen things. You don't see Allah, but you believe in Him. You don't see the angel, but you believe in Him. You don't see the hereafter, but you believe in Him. You don't see the spirit, but you believe in Him. So this is the reason you are a believer, brother. No blame. Wait for the reward. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise that if you are a believer, inshallah, welcome in Firdaus al-A'la ma'a al-Nabiyyina wa-Siddiqina wa-Shuhada'i wa-Al-Anbiya'i wa-Hasuna Ula'ika Rafiqa. Allahumma ya Rabbana, ij'alna mimman yasma'una al-Qawla fa-yattabuna ahsana. If ever somebody have this topic, you have a few points, praise it, but in the same time, if he doesn't believe, just walk away, walk toward the Jannah, walk toward the Al-Firdaus Al-A'la, walk toward the Hawd Al-Kawthar, walk toward the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, and Musa and Isa, and all this great Prophet we have in our life. Peace be upon all of them. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَجَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا أَحْسَنَ مَعَكُمْ. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Thank you, Sheikh, for the Sheikh Tariq. Jazakumullah khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you twice tonight, inshallah. Number one, because you sacrificed and you come during this rain. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you full reward, inshallah. Thank you, Sheikh.